By faith we see the hand of God. In the light of creation's grand design. In the lives of those who prove His faithfulness. Who walk by faith and not by sight.
Good morning and happy Wednesday to you. Welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. I'm Clint Davis, your host, the pastor of our church. Thank you for being with us. As we gather together this morning, we gather together to the praise and glory of our God for a little brief devotional thought from Psalm 97. Psalm 97 begins in my Bible with the heading, A Song of Praise to the Sovereign Lord. It's commonplace to call God sovereign. It's commonplace to think about God as a God who has a perfect and complete and totally wonderful will for all things. My grandmother used to tell me, she'd say, well, if the Lord wills it, it'll happen. The Lord wants it this way. I was recently having a conversation with a director of a camp, and he said, the Lord is in control, and we trust Him in all things. We will do what He wishes for us to do. And I think it's a wonderfully encouraging and comforting reality to think about God in that way. He is a sovereign God who has a will. The idea of God's sovereignty is an idea that says that God has a decree and a will for all things to be the way that they are. And He has planned it out, and He will execute His plan. So when we think about God and His sovereignty, we think about a will, we think about a desire, we think about a decree, a plan for all things to be. We also think about God who has power to execute that plan. We think about God as a sovereign. He's a God who has not only the authority of the will and the authority of the decree, but He's also one who has power to execute that decree. Power to execute that will. And so God is our God, is a sovereign God. He's a king who has power to execute His will, to accomplish the things that He desires to accomplish. We're going to see that in Psalm 97 this morning. We think about God as a God who is in complete and total control of everything that happens in the world, all the forces of nature, all the scary things that are going on around the psalmist. And yet he knows that his trust is in the Lord, who is sovereign over all of that. We also know that God is a God who has the power to preserve His people in the midst of all of that. He is the God who has the power to intervene. He is a God who has the power to overcome. He is a God who has raised the Lord Jesus from the dead. And if He can do that, He can do anything. And so God has a purpose and a plan. You think about it just in the context of the salvation that we receive from the gracious hand of God. We sinned and fell short of His glory. All of us sinned in Adam's first sin. We've all sinned. We all deserve death. We all get death. But God had a plan and a purpose to overcome death. And He overcame it in the Lord Jesus Christ. And here's the thing. It was God's plan for us to be created good and right and true with the capacity to fall. It was God's plan for us to fall. And it was God's plan to send forth Jesus so that He could save us and reveal Himself most fully to us. Now that's hard for some of us to grasp, but the reality of it is that not only did God have a plan and a sovereign will over it, and a sovereign purpose for it, He had the power to execute that plan and to accomplish your salvation and mine by raising forth the Lord Jesus Christ from the dead. Praise be to His holy name. Here's Psalm 97. The Lord reigns, let the earth rejoice, let the multitude of isles be glad. Clouds and darkness surround Him. Righteousness and justice are the foundations of His throne. A fire goes before Him and burns up His enemies around about Him. His lightnings light the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax at the presence of the Lord. You see the power of God here. The heavens declare His righteousness, and all the peoples see His glory. You see the power. You see the sovereignty. These things are subject to Him, and they know it. Let all people be put to shame who serve carved images, who boast of idols. Worship Him, all you gods. Zion hears and is glad. And the daughter of Judah rejoice because of your judgments, O Lord. For you, Lord, are most high above all the earth. You are exalted above all gods. You who love the Lord hate evil. He preserves the souls of His saints. He delivers them out of the hand of the wicked. Light is shown for the righteous, and gladness for the upright in heart. Rejoice in the Lord, you righteous, and give thanks at the remembrance of His holy name. You guys rejoice today and give thanks to God as you remember His holy and wonderful name. Have a great day. God bless you. I'll see you tomorrow, Thursday. Take care.